Hi children, Namaste, welcome to the class. This is Srinivas sir. You are watching Srinivas sir YouTube channel. This is Social Studies, Class 6th, Lesson 9, Community Decision Making in a Tribe. Lesson 9th, Community Decision Making in a Tribe, Part 1. Dear children, what shall we discuss in this lesson? We shall discuss about who are called tribes, why do they called tribes, what are the main characteristics of the tribe, what are the major occupations of the tribes, in what way are the people of a tribe equal, how do tribes take decisions about matters of the common concern, how do they settle disputes among their members? What is called the panch? What are the some important functions of the panch? What is called patla? What is the relation between the panch and the patla? What is the special role of a patla? When can a patla be removed? All these questions will be discussed in this lesson. Let us start. Dear children, before going to learn the lesson, first we should know what is the meaning of a community. What is called a community? Community means a group of people sharing a common understanding and often the same language, manners, tradition and law. I'm repeating once again. A group of people living in a place and sharing a common understanding and the same language, same manners and same law. In this lesson, we are going to discuss how a community, how a group of people take decisions, how a group of people make decisions among themselves. Let us start. In this lesson, the first topic is tribes, societies where all the people are equal. Tribes, societies where all the people are equal. Who are called tribes? Who are called tribes? Different kinds of societies who generally live in forest areas are called tribes. I am repeating once again. Different kinds of societies who generally live in forest areas are called tribes. The people who live in forest areas are called tribes. There are many tribes in our country. The tribes, all the tribes togetherly called Adivasis. The tribes are also known as Adivasis in our country, India. Are there any tribes in our Telangana? Are there any tribes in our Telangana? Yes, there are many tribes in our Telangana. There are different tribal communities in our Telangana. They are Chenchus, Kondareddis, Gonds, Koyas and Savaras. I am repeating once again. Chenchus, Kondareddis, Gonds, Koyas, Savaras. These are the important tribes in our Telangana. The tribes not only living in our Telangana state, but also other states like Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Odisha, Bihar, almost all the states of our country have one tribe or the other living in forests. Almost all the states of our country have one tribe or the other tribes living in the forests. The maximum population of tribes in India is Odisha, Rajasthan, Bengal, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Gujarat, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, and Karnataka. The maximum number of tribal people living in Odisha, Rajasthan, Bengal, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Gujarat, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, and Karnataka. The largest number of tribes, Adivasis, are living in Madhya Pradesh and Bihar. The largest number of Adivasis living in Madhya Pradesh and Bihar in India. In India, tribes refers to a section of the population who are indigenous to the state or region and who live away from the main society. The tribes are indigenous people to the state or region and live away from the main society. The indigenous people, a tribe, possesses certain qualities and characteristics that make it a unique cultural, social, and political entity. There are many tribal communities in India. All the tribal communities are not same. There are many differences from one tribe to another tribe. Each and every tribal community has a unique language, a unique culture, a unique tradition, and a special social and political life. All the tribal communities are not same. They are different from one another. They are different from others. They all have different ways of life, different languages, cultures, etc. They all are not same. They speak different languages. They pray different gods. They follow different cultures and traditions. So, their languages are different, their gods are different, their traditions are different, their cultures are different, their rules are different. So, everything is different from one tribe to another tribe. So, all the tribal communities are not same in India. They follow different ways. Why are they called tribes? Despite these differences, there are many differences in tribal communities. Why do we call them as tribes? Why? Because they share certain common characteristics. They have some common characteristics. They share some common characteristics. What are they? What are the common characteristics of the tribes? There are mainly six common characteristics. The tribal communities share commonly six main characteristics. The first one is, usually, all the members of a tribe consider themselves to be descendants of a common ancestor. Dear children, here, descendants means, ancestor means, here, descendants means successor, means Varasulu. Descendants means Varasulu. Ancestor means forefather. Purvikulu. Ancestor means forefathers, Purvikulu. One from whom a person is descended, whether on the father's or mother's side, at any distance of time. Dear children, here ancestor means forefathers. Forefather means not for, F-O-U-R, for. Here, F-O-R-E, for, F-A-T-H-E-R, father, forefather. That means our fathers, grandparents, and their parents, and their parents, and their parents. That means the parents who lived some thousands of years ago. Here, the tribal community people consider themselves, they were the successors of the forefathers. That means they thought their parents are common. They came from the same parents. Therefore, all the members of a tribe consider themselves to be each other relatives. So the first characteristics of a tribe is, the tribal community people believed considered themselves to be the descendants of a common ancestor. Therefore, all the members of a tribe consider themselves to be each other relatives. The second one is, they believe that all their resources like land, forests, pastures, and water are the common wealth of the entire tribe and not of individual families or persons. Therefore, all the members of the tribe can share and use these resources subject to the rules they frame together. Dear children, here the natural resources are used by all the members of the community. All the members of the community. Here the what are the natural resources? The natural resources are land, forests, pastures, and water. We know already without water, without land, we cannot produce any food. So land, water, forests, pastures, all are very important. So the members of the tribal community share and use all these as a commonwealth. Any member of the community do not have any individual property as like we. In our towns and cities, we have our own property, our own lands, but the tribal people do not have their own lands. All the resources are belong to everyone. So what we have understood? All the natural resources are the commonwealth of the entire tribe, and the members of the tribe can share and use these resources subject to the rules they frame together. Third one, in tribal societies, there are no acute differences like rich and poor, as everyone has a share in the common resources of the tribe. In tribal community, there are no rich people, there are no poor people. All are equal. Why? Because everyone has right to share. Everyone share equally all the resources they get. So that is why there are no rich, no poor, as like we in the towns and cities. In towns and cities, there are poor people, there are rich people. But in tribal community, there are no poor people, there are no rich people. All are equal. So every person, every member of the tribal community treated as equal. There are no differences among them. Why there are no rich, no poor in tribal community? Why the tribal members treated equally? We know already land is most important resource. We cannot produce any food without land. So in tribal community, the total land, the whole land may be divided equally among all the families who are living in that area. Depending upon the size of the family, each and every family will get some piece of land. If there are more members, they will get more land. If there are less members, they will get less land. Finally, each and every family has some piece of land. In some cases, once in a few years, all the land may be redistributed or redivided among the families. Why? Because the size of the family, the members of the family sometimes increases, sometimes decreases. Why? Because births and deaths are common in any society. So, births and deaths may increase or decrease the number of the family members. So, according to the family members, once in a few years, all the land may be redistributed or redivided among the families. In some tribal communities, all the members may till the soil together and share the produce equally. So in some tribal communities, all the members of the community till the soil together, till the land together and share the produce. share the produce equally. No one can sell the land given to them as the entire tribe is considered as the owner of that land. No one can keep more land than they can till or use. Fourth one, generally, all the families of a tribe do all kinds of work like cultivation, gathering food from the forests, grazing animals, and making clothes, baskets, tools, etc. So what we have understood, all the families in the community do all kinds of work togetherly. Every member of the family, every family of the community do all kinds of works like cultivation, gathering food from the foresters, grazing animals, and making clothes, baskets, tools, etc. Fifth one, women, men, and even children share the work of the family. Just now we have discussed already, women, men, and children do all activities of the family, all works of the family. However, in many tribes, men have greater power and role in decision making than women. We knew already, in every family, in our societies too, men have greater power and role in decision making in the family. In tribal community too, men have greater power and role in decision making than women. So the fifth one is, men have greater power and role in decision making. Sixth one, the tribes give a lot of importance to the celebration of festivals and rituals to please the tribal gods and ancestors. They also have distinct beliefs, customs, songs, dances, and arts and crafts. Dear children, we know already the importance of festivals and rituals. We also celebrate number of festivals like Deepavali, Dasara, Batukamma, Muharram, Bakrid, Christmas. So many festivals are there. We can celebrate number of festivals in our society. The tribal community people also celebrate different festivals according to their customs and traditions. Dear children, we also celebrate different festivals. We also pray different gods. We also worship different gods. For example, village deities like Pochamma, Ellamma, Gangamma. Like that, the tribal community people also worship different gods, different village deities. For example, in fifth lesson, Pengolu lesson, we have discussed already, the Koyas worship Muthyalamma. The Koyas worshipped Muthyalamma goddess. They also celebrate Peddala Panduga and Kodathala Panduga. See the video carefully, children. These are called Kondareddis. So the large number of Kondareddis celebrate Mamidi Panduga at the end of the summer season and beginning of the rainy season. See children, they are dancing. They are celebrating Mamidi Panduga. They also have some special beliefs, customs, songs, dances, and arts and crafts. Each and every tribal community has special beliefs, special customs, special songs, special dances, and arts and crafts. By these six characteristics, what we have understood, we can call them as tribes. Once again, I will recall you what we have learnt already. All the members of a tribe consider themselves to be descendants of a common ancestor. Second one, resources like land, forests, pastures and water are the common wealth of the entire tribe, and there is no acute difference like rich and poor. And all the families of the tribe do all kinds of work. Fifth one, men have greater power and role in decision making than women. Last one, sixth one, the tribes give a lot of importance to the celebration of festivals and rituals.
కలు రంగురంగుల పూసలు ప్లాస్టిక్ పువ్వులతో అలంకరించిన పాగా లాంటి వస్తువు చేతిలో చెక్కదండలు కట్టి తుపాకులు మనసులో తమ ఆరాధ్య దైవాన్ని కొలుచుకుని వేడుకలు నిర్వహించే గిరిజనులు మంచిర్యాల జిల్లాలో జరిగే ఆ దండారి విశేషాలేంటో ఒకసారి చూద్దాం.
మంచిర్యాల జిల్లా దండేపల్లి మండలం గుడిరేవు గ్రామంలో కొలువై ఉన్న గిరిజనుల ఆరాధ్య దైవం పద్మల్పురి కాకు అమ్మవారు ఆలయంలో జరిగిన అమ్మవారి వార్షిక దండారి ఉత్సవాలకు రాష్ట్ర నలుమూలలతో పాటు మహారాష్ట్ర ఛత్తీస్గఢ్ నుంచి కూడా భారీగా గిరిజనులు తరలివచ్చారు. తమ ఆరాధ్య దైవానికి ప్రత్యేక పూజలు నిర్వహించి మొక్కులు చెల్లించుకున్నారు. ప్రతి ఏటా దీపావళి పర్వదినం సందర్భంగా సుమారు నెల రోజుల పాటు గోండులు ఎంతో నియమనిష్టలతో ఈ ఉత్సవాన్ని జరుపుకుంటారు. ప్రత్యేక దీక్షలు చేపట్టి పద్మల్పూరి కాకో దర్శనంతో పవిత్ర దీక్షలు ముగిస్తారు. ఈ ఆలయంలో జరిగే గిరిజన దర్బారుకు భారీగా తరలివచ్చి గోండులు తమ తమ కొత్త కోడళ్లను తీసుకొచ్చి ప్రత్యేక పరిచయ కార్యక్రమం నిర్వహిస్తారు. ఈ సందర్భంగా సంస్కృతి సాంప్రదాయాలు ఉట్టిపడేలా డప్పు వాయిద్యాలతో ప్రదర్శించిన గుస్సాడి నృత్యాలు ఆహుతులను ఆకట్టుకున్నాయి. ఆ ప్రకృతిని ఆరాధిస్తారు. అడవి తల్లిని పూజిస్తూ జరుపుకునే పండుగే అకాడి. జూలై మాసం వచ్చిందంటే ఆదివాసీలు ప్రత్యేక ఏర్పాట్లు చేసుకుంటారు. అమావాస్య ముగిసిన 5 రోజుల తర్వాత చంద్రుణ్ణి చూసి అడవి అధిపతైన రాజుల్ పేన్ దేవుణ్ణి పూజిస్తారు. రాజుల్ పేన్ ప్రకృతి దేవుడు. ఈ దేవుణ్ణి పూజించడం 7 రోజులుగా వస్తున్న ఆచారం. ప్రతి ఏటా ఈ అకాడి మాసంలో రాజుల్ పేన్ ను ప్రతి ఆదివాసీ కూడెం పూజిస్తుంది. ప్రతి ఇంటి నుంచి సేకరించిన పదార్థాలను నైవేద్యంగా వండుతారు. వండిన నైవేద్యాన్ని అడవి అధిపతి అయిన రాజుల దేవుడికి సమర్పిస్తారు. ఈ క్రమంలో గొర్రెలు కోళ్లను బలిస్తారు. తర్వాత అందరూ సహపంక్తి భోజనం చేస్తారు. ప్రకృతి దేవునికి పూజలు చేయడం వల్ల తమకు అష్ట ఐశ్వర్యాలు లభిస్తాయని ఆదివాసీలు విశ్వాసం వ్యక్తం చేశారు. రాజుల్ పేన్ పూజ Thank you.
Dear children, till now we have discussed who are called tribes, why do they call tribes, what are the main characteristics of the tribes, what are the major occupations of the tribes, in what way are the people of a tribe equal. I hope you understood. Remaining questions will be discussed in the next part of this lesson. Thank you for watching.